Good morning to all of you. Now, in the previous exercise, we were able to simulate a flash column, and irrespective of the type of specification that you have used to specify the flash column, we were able to get a consistent result. Now, in case if you want to do this type of specifications when you want to handle flash calculations manually, some of these could be quite tedious. Now, let me deal with the second exercise in the present demonstration. Now we have a binary mixer consisting of 50 mole percent N pentane and 50 mole percent N hexane. This is the temperature and pressure at which the feed is entering into a flash column. Now these are the conditions of the flash unit. Now the new thing that you can observe while doing this exercise is we would like to connect a heat stream, and we will be able to learn how to handle heat or work streams along with the material streams whenever you try to simulate a unit, depending on your requirement. Now let us go into Aspen. In fact, I have already specified the components, N-pentane and N-hexane. These are the two components that we are going to handle. Now the next step is to choose a property method. Let us say Chao-Seder. Say next. Go to simulation environment. Now under separators, choose flash column. Trying to magnify this. Now connect material streams. So this is the feed stream. Now this is the vapor product and this is the liquid product. Say next. Now we know the conditions. I think the units that we are going to adopt in this exercise happen to be PSI and degrees Fahrenheit. So 130 degrees Fahrenheit, 73.5. So I'd like to change the unit system to English. So the entering temperature is 130 degrees centigrade, 73.5 psi. Let us assume the flow rate as we would like to calculate the vapor fraction and the composition. So let me assume the flow rate as 1 lb mole per hour. Now the mole fractions. Now you see you have 50 mole percent N pentane and 50 mole percent N hexane. So the mole fractions are 0.5 and 0.5. So we have specified stream 1. Now no information is required with respect to stream 2 and 3. So go to next input screen. Now we are required to specify the temperature and pressure with respect to this block. The block is operating at a temperature of 120 degrees Fahrenheit and a pressure of 13.23 psi. Let me verify that. Yeah, 13.23 psi. Now we have specified the block. Then you will be able to, the required input is complete. Now you will be able to run the simulation. Yeah. Now you will be able to see the results. Stream summary. Now you can see what is the amount of vapor generated, about 30% out of the 1 lb mole per hour of feed that is entering into the column, 0.303 lb moles per hour of vapor is generated. About 70% liquid is coming from the bottom. So the vapor fraction is going to be 30%. The liquid fraction is roughly about 70%. Now if you are interested in looking at the composition of these streams, now you may have to include the mole fractions or mass fractions in your report. Stream, mole fraction, say next. Okay. Now you will be able to see the stream summary once again. Now you can see what is the composition. Now N-pentane is more volatile. So you have N-pentane is going to be richer in the vapor product being more volatile, whereas the less volatile component will be richer in the liquid stream. Now this is not the issue. This we have already seen in the previous example. Now let me go into the block and see what is its result. In fact, you can also see the result here. Now what is happening? The reactants are entering at 130 degrees Fahrenheit and the flash column is operating at 120. So what is happening? Q is given to be positive, right? Now let us see why this heat is positive. What do you mean by positive heat? So much of heat must be added to the system. Any energy added to the system is taken as positive, whether it is in the form of heat or work. Any energy removed from the system is to be taken as negative. So in order to have this flash operating at 120 degrees Fahrenheit at this pressure, unless and otherwise you supply this much of heat, you will not be able to get the required composition. Now let me try to show you how to connect a heat stream. Now expand these material streams. Now you can see heat stream. Now you can either connect the heat as input or output. Now I am connecting a heat stream at its output. Now for example, if you try to connect this heat stream to its input, now this also will be treated similar to the material stream that is going to enter into a flash column. As is the case with any rating model, all the input streams, including heat or work streams, must also have to be defined if you are trying to simulate a rating model. Whereas when I put an output stream, now the heat, whatever is it, whether it is added or removed, is going to be computed by the model, and you should be able to see this result. Now let me once again run. Close. Now you can just click on this heat stream. Now what is happening? The Q calculated is minus 30.24. What does that mean? In fact, because this is minus, now the heat is shown to be removed from the system. Now an amount of minus 30.24 calories or whatever it is, BTU per hour, if it is removed, that means so much of heat must be added to the system. Now you will be able to handle the other streams like heat or work more or less in the same way you are handling material streams. In fact, this kind of facility is going to be quite useful if you are looking at heat integration. For example, the heat recovered in one unit, if you would like to transfer that to some other unit, this is the way you will be able to achieve it. For example, in the case of a compressor, you may have to input work, whereas in the case of a turbine, you will be able to get work. In case if you want to integrate these work streams, the work that is obtained from the turbine can be taken as an input to the compressor, and thereby you will be able to achieve overall energy integration. Now in whatever way you are able to handle material streams, like you should be able to split that stream into more than one. In the same way, you can also handle all the other streams as well, like heat, work, and so on. Now, in the same way, wherever you need, you will be able to handle these streams depending on your convenience, especially when you would like to integrate